What's good, fam? This is your man, Jimmy Conway, BeatsForLyricists.com, music production tips. This is my Ableton Live 11 tutorial for beginners session view. If you need to learn the session view for Ableton Live, stick with me here. I'm going to show you very basics of Ableton Live session view. Nothing too crazy, nothing too hard, but yeah, this will get you like the basics to get you up and running, to get some ideas flowing, and just to help you out a little bit, all right? So let's get started. So when you open up Ableton Live 11, it'll look like this, all right? The first thing you want to do is make sure that you have your audio device set up. So you want to go to Preferences on the Live, go to Preferences. Go to audio, go to audio input and output, and make sure you click the drop down and select your audio interface. Okay. I use a Scarlett 8i6. You can check it out in the link in the description below. It's an Amazon link, affiliate link. If you want to change the look and feel of your Ableton Live, go up here where it says look and feel, click here. And then come down here where it says theme, and this is the light theme. This is the mid-light theme. This is the mid-dark theme. This is the dark theme. And this is the Ableton Live 9 theme, if you like the Ableton Live 9 look, all right? Right now, I'm going to leave it on Ableton Live light. Click out of here. And this is what Ableton Live 11 will look like when you first open it up, all right? You'll get two audio tracks, two MIDI tracks. You can delete the tracks if you want. It'll always keep one track just to get you started. And we're going to delete the MIDI tracks today. We're going to delete the MIDI tracks because we're not dealing with MIDI today. We're just going to deal with the audio. So click MIDI. Hit delete. MIDI, delete. Okay. So over here, we have our browser view. This is the main view you're going to use when you're going to be dragging and dropping loops, MIDI files, audio effects, MIDI effects, whatever it is. You're going to be dragging and dropping from over here in the browser view. Okay. So over here, you have your sounds. These sounds go with the instruments over here. It just depends on how you want to search for sounds, whether you want to use a certain instrument or whether you want to just look for a particular sound, okay? Over here, you have your audio effects for Ableton Live 11. These are your MIDI effects. These are your plugins. These are your VST plugins or your audio units plugins for the Logic users. These are your Ableton Live clips, so you can drag and drop clips from here, anywhere in here. Delete. Okay. You have more samples in AIFF format, and you have what is this? My bad. Grooves. Grooves are your different quantization presets. They have everything from the MPC presets to SP1200 to Logic. They have everything in here as far as MIDI quantization presets. They have rock presets, swing presets, presets with triplets. We're not going to get into that now because that's more of a slightly advanced, you know, move. All right. So down below, you have your different packs. The packs you could purchase from Ableton Live, from Ableton's website, or I guess third party websites too. Just come in here. Close all this up. Okay. So it says I have 8 available packs I could download, right? So I come in here. Digicussions 2. Let's see. I'm going to download the Loop Masters mixtape. And I think I want Grand Piano for right now. So let's download those two, see what they, you know. All right, so while that's downloading, these are all my drum kits and my third-party drums that I purchased through wherever I got from wherever, downloaded online. If you scroll all the way down, it has a link that says Add Folder. So if I come over here, click Add Folder, you can search your hard drive and add more folders to your Ableton Live browser, making it easier for you to drag and drop things from your hard drive. Okay, this is still loading up. So over here you got your audio tracks, you have your reverb and delays, delay returns, and you have your master track. In Ableton Live, let me just start by saying Ableton Live has two different views. They have the session view, which is the session view is this right here. And you have the more linear view, the arranger view, which is more familiar to different, you know, if you have any other DAW, this is more familiar to what you're used to seeing. All right. If I hit the tab button, it'll bring me back to session view. All right. So you got your reverb, you got your delay. Let's start from the top. You can tap tempo your tempo in. You have your time signature. You have your metronome here. With the metronome, you can change it to different things like how many bars you want it to come in on the count in, what kind of sound you want it to have, and the rhythmic pattern you want it to have, all right? I usually have mine just at the one bar count-ins. Okay, saying I could install my grand piano, so let's install that now. Okay, right here, this is the follow button right here with this button. Whenever your session is playing, it's gonna follow the session where the timeline is, all right? This is your bars and beats. Give it a second to finish installing. Okay, there you go. Here's your play button, stop button, and record button for the arranger view, for this view. Over here you have overdub for MIDI tracks. Oh, and down here, if you have this enabled, is your help right here. So whatever you hover over, it'll have a tip for you. So if I hover over the overdub, you'll see it says MIDI arrangement overdub, and you can read what it's about. All right. This record button is for the session view. So if I want to record a clip into the session clip here, I can. Okay. Let's see. This is your loop button. So to make sure everything's looping, make sure that's clicked in. Let's see, we're going to keep this basic, okay? If you want to clear up some of the space in here, maybe it's too cluttered for your taste, you can click here to get more real estate. If you click this, this will get rid of the inputs and outputs on your each track. So this is an audio track, right? If I go down, this is my input. I'm sorry, this is my input right here where I select my audio interface's input. This is the monitoring section. You could leave it off or you could put it in if you have an effects. If you have effects running while you're recording, you might want to put that in so you can hear it with the effects. Then you have your sends right here. You have two sends. So you can send your signal to your reverb and your delay units. Below that, you have your dB meter, your meter here. You could pan left and right with the pan here. Here's your volume. This is your mute. You have mute, you have solo, and you have ready record, all right, on each audio track. So over here, we can get rid of the inputs and outputs if we don't need those. Now you see that they're gone. You can get rid of your sends and returns. Your sends and your returns. That's the S and the R here. So that's my sends. That's my returns. All right. So now, you know, just to free up space and free up, you know, if you don't like the clutter, I don't mind it because I'm used to it now. All right. So that's the basics of the session view interface. So now we're going to start dragging in some loops, all right? So let's drag in some loops from over here. Give me a second. I'm going to download my drums all to one track. Let's see. Put the bass on the next audio track. Oops, sorry. Just keep dragging and dropping where it says drop files and devices here. So I'm going to grab my, let me rephrase what I was just about to say. I'm about to grab my organ. Pause. Oh, gosh. I'm going to drag and drop my organ over here. Get my strings over here. And my synth pad over here. Now, there's a lot of tracks going on here. So what I could do is I could resize everything. If I click the first track, right, the drums, then I scroll to the last track, right? If I hit shift and the last track, it'll highlight everything. Now, if I go in between any track, it'll bring up the little bracket. If I click the bracket and move it in, you'll see it closes down, okay? Just so I can see everything. Now, let me see if I can get some more loops in here, all right? I'm going to try to get something in the same key. Give me 1 second. Okay, so now we have a bunch of clips, and each row has a similar clips in a row. So, like, this one is all drums. If I had more basses, I put them in here. If I had more analog stuff, I put it here. But I have some keyboard stuff here, like an organ and a clav. have an organ and a voice. Here are my strings, and here are some synths and some leads, all right? So if I click cell one on track one, it'll play my little drum beat. Now you see up here where it says, if I want to stop it, just click the stop button on any track down here, and it'll stop it, all right? Now, if you see right here where it says one bar, that one bar is how long it's going to take, or how long it's going to take before the next loop I click comes in. Let me just do it for you. So if I have this beat going right now, right? If I click this, the next drums is not going to start until the end of this beat. So one, two, three, four, one, two, see? Four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, switch. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna lower the volume for this. We're gonna lower the volume just because, let's take this off. We're gonna lower the volume because all these tracks together are gonna create a lot of volume going to the master track, which is gonna create distortion. I could add a limiter on the final track, and I may do that still, but let's try to lower the tracks. So we'll start with the drums. Okay, so now we're gonna click the bass. Now the bass is not gonna come in until the end of the bar. Four, one, two, Got a little bass line. Now let's drop this analog sound down a little bit. Four, one, two, three, four. Now I'm going to add the organ in. Let's drop the volume down. Now we're going to add some strings. Strings are too loud. Let's bring them down. Bring them down. Now we're going to add a synth lead. A synth pad. That's cool, right? Now I could click them all one at a time. If I want to stop them all, I could just hit the pause button. Or if they're all playing like this, I could hit the stop button at the below. If they're all playing at the same time, I could hit the stop button on the master track like this. And all the tracks will stop, okay? So if you want to start, every row going across like this is called a, oh man, blacked out. These are different cells. And you click over here. Each one of these have a play button. I blacked out. I forgot the terms wrong. Gosh, I'm crazy right now. this will play everything in this row, all the cells in this row. This will play all the cells in row two. So if I hit play here, you'll see they all start at the same time. Now I can do the same thing for the second row. So I might want to start like this real quick. So these play buttons will just play everything in a row, okay? So you can also add effects to each track. So let's say I'm on track one. Let's stop everything. I can add effects to the drums, or I can add effects to anything pretty much. If I come over here, I can add the audio effects that Ableton gives me. Let's just show you. Or I know a lot of you probably want to use your own third-party effects. So let's go to plugins. I'm going to go to local and find out what do I want to put on my drums real quick. I'll put a, let me put a filter on real quick. So, I didn't want that filter either. To put an effect on your any sound, just click the track that you want to add the effects to. Find your effects in the VST folder, and then drag and drop. All right, so now we have a little filter here. So do some adjustments real quick. Okay, so you can add effects. You can also double click on any cell to open up its properties. So let me double click on, let's see, what do we want? Let's do just do drums, forget it. All right, and it'll give you some properties about the drums. It's telling me that the drums are here are 71 beats a minute normally, but with the warping on, the warping makes it so that, the warping makes it so that the drums will match the tempo of your project. So if I have a project at 85 beats a minute or 90 beats a minute, if this is perfectly chopped into a perfect loop and you set the loop button here and you hit the warp on, everything's going to match the tempo. Your drum beat will match to whatever tempo your project is. And I'll show you stuff on time stretching and warping in another video. Like I said, that's another advanced video for the warping part. But you could tell the loop where you wanted to start. So right now you see the little, as you can see, it starts at bar three now. Now I have it set to start at bar three. Let's go back to one. Excuse me. You can turn the loop on and off. This tells me how long the loop is. It's an 8-bar loop. The warping is set to beats. All these other parameters here are for different types of, like, if you're time stretching or warping chords, warping single shots, warping, sorry. Because we're warping a drum beat, or we're time stretching a warp beat. Oh, excuse me. Because we're warping a beat, we're gonna leave this parameter set to beats. All of these other parameters here are for different types of musical elements, like chords, single shots, mono kind of sounds, and things of that nature. All right. You can adjust the gain of the clip here. So if you look, you can see the gain going smaller and gain going larger. You can change the pitch. Okay. Now let me see if I can record myself on a clip, just to show you, you can record also onto a clip. Let me see. Do I need this anymore? I don't think I do. So I hope you get the point with the session view. Let me, let's open another track. You can hit Control T. Control T will open up another audio track. Empty one. So if I hit ready record, set my input for input one, I see my levels moving pretty nicely. Now if I hit record here, it should record some vocals. Oh, there we go. And this is just going to test to make sure everything is working properly. I'm probably sitting too close to my mic, and this is showing me right now that I need a pop filter, which I don't have. So that'll be my next investment. All right, so so that just shows you how to record audio onto a clip. If I hit record, it should record some vocals. Oh, there we go. So now I'm just going to bring down the audio. This is just going to test to make sure everything is working properly. I'm probably sitting too close to my mic, and this is showing me right now that I need a pop filter, which I don't have. So that'll be my next investment. If I hit record, it should. Okay. So as you can see, you can record onto the session view using the record button here, and it gives you a one bar counting. All right. So is there anything else I need to show you on the session view for a beginner tutorial? Oh, an easy way to find sounds and your different effects and stuff like that is the search bar here. This is one of my favorite tools, probably the most underutilized tool in here. I love this tool because if you have, let's say, you're one of those guys with, or one of those girls with, thousands of plugins and thousands and thousands of plugins, and you can't find the plugin because there's too many plugins showing up. I can go to wherever my plugin folder is. Let's see. Go to my plugin folder. Let's go to VST. And I could type in, let's say, if I know I want to use an EQ. There's an EQ I purchased. I forgot the name of it. It was so long ago. I installed it and never used it, never tried it. Hit EQ. And it'll tell you it's in the plugin folder. I'm going to go to VST. Go to local. A lot of my plugins I get from Plugin Alliance or Plugin Boutique. But then now it shows me all the EQs that I have that I purchased from different companies. If I want a compressor, I do the same thing. Just type in COM. And it'll show you different compressors. All right. You can drag and drop. And if you hit this little toolbar here, it'll bring up the compressor. All right. Is there anything else? I think that's it. Yeah, I think that's it for my beginner tutorial on the session view for Ableton Live 11. I hope you liked the tutorial. I know it was kind of long. I hope you stuck with it, and I hope you got something out of it. And if you want to see more videos for Ableton Live 11, tell me what you would like to learn in the comments below, and I will create a video on it as soon as possible. Sorry for the long delay in between videos. I've been working some pretty crazy shifts, and yeah. So yeah, if you need some more help on Ableton Live 11, drop a comment below. Let me know what you want to see. This is the session view. My next video will probably be the arranger view. And that's it. This is your man, Jimmy Conway. If it's your first time here, click the description below. Click the link in the description below, the first link. It'll be a link to my free drum kit. My free personal drum kit to you for... It's my thank you for watching this video all in its entirety. If you've been here before, or even if you haven't been here before, it's your first time, also go to the description below and check out Loop Cloud. Loop Cloud is going to integrate with this flawlessly, and I'm going to be showing you that in the future too. Loop Cloud is a loop-based app. It's a loop app that lets you, that gives you access to about 4 million different loops and one shots that you could drag and drop into your projects, all royalty free. You don't have to worry about getting snatched up. And that I'll show you in another video too. That's another advanced kind of video to show you. All right, so yeah, check out Loop Cloud, check out the Loop Masters link, all attached to my Beats for Lyricists website. And this is your man, Jimmy Conway, for BeatsForLyricists.com, music production tips. Make sure you check the links in the description below. If you want to see what my studio looks like, check out the Amazon links below. If you buy anything through the Amazon links, those are my affiliate links. I'd really appreciate it. That's how I support the channel for now. And I'm out. I don't want to keep you here. I'm out. I need to make some more beats and make some more videos. One love.